why are you untying it? He shall say, the Lord has need of it. So those were sent away. So those were sent away and found it as he had told them.
We must celebrate, praise you, Lord. We must celebrate.
Jesus drew near and saw the city, he wept over it, saying, "Would that even today you knew the things that make for peace, but now they are hidden from your eyes. O Jerusalem, the day shall come upon you when your enemies will cast up a bank about and surround you, and hem you in on every side, and dash you to the ground, you and your children within you. And they will not leave one stone upon another in you, because you did not know the time of your visitation." Now the feast of unleavened bread drew near, which is called the Passover. And the temple priests were seeking how to put Jesus to death, for they feared the people.
Then Satan entered into Judas called Iscariot, who was one of the 12. He went away and conferred with the temple priests and officers how he might betray Jesus to them. And they were glad and agreed to give him money. So he agreed and sought an opportunity to betray him in the absence of the crowds.
Then came the day of unleavened bread, on which the Passover lamb had been sacrificed. So Jesus sent Peter and John, saying, "Go and prepare the Passover for us, that we may eat."
They said to him, "But where, Lord? Where are we asked to prepare? And what are we to do?"
Jesus said to them, "Behold, when you have entered the city, a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him into the house which he enters, and tell the householder, 'The teacher says to you, where is the guest room where I am to eat the Passover with my disciples?' And he will show you a large upper room furnished. There make bread." And they went and found it as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. And when the hour came, Jesus sat at the table, and the apostles with him. And he said to them, "I have earnestly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I shall not eat it again until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God." And he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he said, "Take this and divide it among yourselves. For I tell you that from now on I shall not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes." And he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And likewise the cup after supper, saying, "This cup which is poured out for you is the new covenant in my blood. But behold, the hand of him who betrays me is with me at the table. For the Son of Man goes as it has been determined, but woe to that man by whom he is betrayed." He answered, "He who has dipped his hand in the dish with me will betray me. Oh, it would have been better for that man if he had not been born."
Judas, who betrayed him, said, "Is it I, Master?"
Jesus said to him, "You have said so."
Simon Peter was indignant. "But not I," he said. And he declared, "Though they all fall away from you, I will never leave you."
"Peter, truly I say to you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times.
Peter said to him, "Even if I must die with you, I will never deny you."
And so said all the disciples, over and over again.
Thank you.
them, pray that you may not enter into temptation.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
And he withdrew from them about a stone's throw and knelt down and prayed, Father, if thou art willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, thy will be done, thy will be done.
And when he rose from prayer, he came to the disciples and found them sleeping for sorrow. And he said to them, Why do you sleep? Rise and pray that you may not enter into temptation.
There came a crowd, and a man called Judas, one of the 12, was leading them. He drew near to Jesus to kiss him.
But Jesus said to him, Judas, would you betray the Son of Man with a kiss?
Judas said, Hail, Master.
When the disciples saw him follow, they said, Our Lord shall be struck with the sword.
And one of them struck the slave of the high priest, cut off his right ear.
But Jesus said, No more of this! And he touched his ear and healed him.
Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Jesus said to those who had come up against him, When I was with you day after day in the temple, you did not lay your hands on me. But this is your hour. Said to them, You say that I am.
And they said, Blasphemy.
Then the whole company of them arose and brought Jesus before Pontius Pilate.
And then they began to murder him, saying, "We found this man perverting our nation, and forbidding us to give tribute to Caesar, and saying that he himself is Christ the King."
And Pilate asked him, "Are you the King of the Jews?"
And he answered them, "You have said so."
And Pilate said to the chief priests and the crowd, "I find no crime in this man."
But they were urgent, saying, "He stirs up the people, teaching throughout Galilee, even to this place."
But when Pilate heard that he was a Galilean of Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him to Herod,
where he was vehemently accused and treated with contempt and mocked, arrayed in gorgeous purple, and then sent back again.
Pilate said to the ruler of the people, "You brought me this man as one who was perverting the people, and after examining him, behold, I did not find him guilty of any of the charges against him. Behold, nothing deserving death has been done by him. I will therefore have him whipped and release him." Pilate addressed them once more, desiring to release Jesus.
But they shouted out, "Crucify him! Crucify him!"
"Why? What evil has he done? I found no crime in him deserving death. I'll whip him. I'll release him."
But they were urgent, demanding the blood of Christ to be executed.
And their voices prevailed.
So Pilate gave sentence that their demand should be granted. He released the man who had been jailed for murder, but he delivered Jesus up to their will.
Thank you.
brothers also, who were criminals, were led away to be put to death with him. And when they came to the place which is called the Skull, there they crucified him and the criminals, one on the right hand and one on the left.
Last. Oh, the temple is sealed.
town of Arimathea. A good man, a righteous man, one looking for the kingdom of God. This man went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Joseph took it down and wrapped it in a linen shroud and laid Jesus in a rock-hewn tomb, which had never been used.
It was the day of preparation, and the Sabbath was beginning.
The women who had come with him had already called, and saw the tomb.
On the Sabbath, they rested according to the